I want to invite to the stage Eran and Eyal. Eran is a very interesting person. Actually, Eran is a serial entrepreneur. He launched and successfully exited three businesses already. And now Eran is developing a new one, which is called Shopin, which is actually the future of Amazon, the Amazon on blockchain, the decentralized Amazon. But Eran will tell himself about the project. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thanks for joining us today. I know it's been a long day, and I hope what I have to tell you is going to excite you. Because early on today, we talked about applications that make a big difference for users. Not crypto people, but the average user. By the way, I'm really proud to announce that we were actually, just last week, the winners of Coin Agenda Global. We're building a decentralized Amazon on the blockchain. Here's an interesting thing. So we all know that, one second, I think that this thing is skipping slides. Okay, so we all know that e-commerce is a massive opportunity. But here's the rub. Only 7% of retailers can actually identify their users across different channels and different devices. Doesn't that sound ludicrous to you? If you don't know who your customer is, how can you possibly sell to him or her? So there are massive inefficiencies. And it's time for the retailers to wake up, because this man over here is coming to eat their lunch. I'm not an Amazon hater. I mean, I own Amazon shares. I think it's amazing. And Amazon consumes 30% of the e-commerce world. But there's 70% that's pushing back. What we do at Shopin is that we give retailers the thing that they're looking for. User-verified preferences from the user, and the full purchase history from all the retailers that that user exists on to drive perfect product recommendations and marketing. So how it works? Basically, the retailer works with us to advertise Shopin to their own marketplace of users. The user opts in, and we take in the inventory, the verified preferences via a quick shopper IQ game. And we take in all their previous purchase history from the retailer. We then create an enhanced consumer profile. I apologize, I don't know why, but there's a whole bunch of slides that are missing here. So what we do from that point is, is there something wrong with this machine, because all my slides are missing? So I'll move on. But basically what we do is that we take in all the purchase history from the retailer. We then go into our real-time network of all the retailers who joined, and we check to see if your data exists there. And you know what we do? We call in the purchase history that exists with all the inventory information, and we give it to you, the user, the perfect person to own it. And what happens from this point is that, I really apologize, nothing seems to be working here. There's supposed to be a video here. So what we do is basically we then serve a page on the retailer's site called the Just For You page, where we take in their inventory and we show you the inventory that matters. Okay, so all the stuff that is relevant to all your purchase history from across the web, and we can do that because you're the owner of the purchase history. We have a really interesting team, some of which are clearly missing from these slides. You don't need these slides. So, who's our team? Myself, I've had three exits, but the more interesting people inside our team executing on this vision is my CTO, my longtime friend. He was the CTO, he was the first and principal engineer at Priceline, who for 14 years engineered Priceline's solution. The same solution you use today, he engineered that and architected that. Sitting alongside him is Mike Rizzo, who was the VP of Engineering of Priceline for 15 years, responsible for all consumer-facing technology, as well as Abhishek Yermala. And Abhishek was the VP of Engineering at Priceline for 10 years. They've done this before and in massive scale. Also joining us today and sitting right over there is Michael Herman, our CRO, who used to be the president of global sales at Eli Tahari, as well as SVP at Valentino, DKNY, and has spent a long time inside the retail industry. So we can go directly to about a list of 55 retailers, and we speak to people at the CMO and CEO level and go directly to the people who matter to who can really make a decision on moving forward. We have a very interesting group of advisors as well, including Steve Narayov, the architect of Ethereum, Ethereum's ICO, Jeff Pulver, invested in over 350 startups. All these people help us to make better decisions. Now, here's the interesting things. This is a real project. This is not something hypothetical. We have almost 750,000 users who joined us in 30 days. The interesting thing about these people is that 22% is that we saw a 22% increase in transactional lift from these from the retailers. How did it work? Xenia and Bed Bath & Beyond sent out their emails to their database. 1 million people from Xenia, 4 million people from Bed Bath & Beyond. 120,000 people out of the 1 million people of Xenia joined within 30 days. They generated $1.7 million for Xenia, representing a 22% increase in lift in transactional conversion over the users purchasing the same product. Why? Because they see the products that are relevant to them. With Bed Bath & Beyond, 505,000 people joined within 30 days. And we generated $13 million for them, representing a 22% increase in transactional conversion. These are numbers that can save the industry. What was also interesting that we saw is that we've got a really cool feature where users can share their Shopin profile with friends and family. So when it comes time for gifting, I could share my Shopin profile with you, and I could share my Shopin profile with you. You can switch on my filter and look at all the different participating retailers on their own websites, buy me the things that are perfect for me, my profile becomes enriched, and you don't wind up buying me this. This was super interesting to us. Why? Because when we started looking at return rates at retailers, who here knows what the return rate at Saks Fifth Avenue is every day? Anyone? 10% in the back, 10% in the back, 20% to the person over there, Fanny and Jacobin, 20%, 30%, is that 30? 45, very close, and you know, I'm gonna give it to you. 40% every day of what goes out of Saks Fifth Avenue comes right back. In season, 65%. 65% return rate. Can you understand why this industry is going bankrupt at one retailer a month? You know why? Because people don't know their size across brands. So they order multiple of the same items, or you wind up getting gifting from other people who give you the same gift as another person, or they give you gifts that don't fit your style and size. I know this because I'm the CTO, the ex-CTO of Saks Fifth Avenue has corroborated this. So these are some of the issues that are assailing the industry. So we can bring greater efficiencies to the industry as well as higher margins and revenues. Why do users love this? Well, first of all, you get an activity feed in your app showing you who's accessing your data and you're in control. Secondly, you get Amazon-like benefits on every website that you go to. It's one-click checkout, you get one wish list for the entire web. Go back to your Shopin profile and you can see all your orders from all the different websites and you can control the returns from one place. And of course, you've got the really brilliant feature to share your Shopin profile with your friends and family. And finally, you get the gifts that you love. So as a user, you have an incredible experience. And to access the data over time, we're launching a Shopin token, which the retailers can pay you for your data to access your data, because we're starting to understand something really special. We're starting to understand what the true lifetime value of a user is based on purchase data across the entire web. Do you buy at full price? Do you buy it in a lower price? Do you return a lot? How are your margins changing? And we can equate that. And this means that our token is backed by the value of data converted into dollars. We've already built our real-time ingestion engine. It can ingest 25 million SKUs in real time. You switch us on, we've ingested 25 million SKUs, broken them down to 25 to 36 key identifiers, and made them applicable to your profile immediately. What we're doing, it's quite interesting, is to kickstart the market, is we haven't gone to the retailers and said, oh, we want to tokenize your system. We all know that's not going to work. Okay? What we're doing instead is saying, pay us $15,000 to $50,000 a month, okay, for the product recommendations that you're going to be receiving, and percentage of lift. These are basic models that they're very used to, nothing weird and nothing strange. But what we're doing is we're taking a large chunk of that money they pay us, and we're actually going to be purchasing tokens directly out of the exchange, thereby creating frothiness from the people who matter, the people who are going to create utility. So it's not just the speculators that are going to drive up the value of our token. It's going to be the actual people who are going to derive utility. So we give the retailers the tokens, and then they start to give it to the users in order to generate market, to accept adverts, and for loyalty and referrals, etc. I'm not going to go too deeply into this. Our initial token offering is going to be on in about the 28th of February next year. However, we are already conducting a very successful private pre-sale that is almost sold out. We are giving a 66% bonus to people who are participating now, over $500,000, 40% for people below. And then when we go into the actual sale itself, we'll be doing a $50 million token sale. And the first $10 million, we're going to give a 20% bonus on. The next $10 million, we're going to give a 17.5% bonus on, and so on. So everybody gets a lot of value, and there's a lot of distribution. We are already being backed by some incredible people like Galaxy Investment Partners, NEMA Capital. We're a venture-backed company. And we're here to open the doors of Shopin to you so that you can shop in all the places that you love without someone controlling the pricing, squeezing the margins, or taking the brand language away from the brands into a new era. So please feel free to reach out to me. I'm Eran from Shopin, and thank you for your time today. Apologies for the technical difficulties.
Thank you, Eran.
Yes, sorry, are there any questions from the crowd? My contact information was up. You can contact me at Eran, Echo Romeo Alpha November, Eran@shopin.com, shopin.com.
Any questions to Eran?
Yes, sir.
How you doing? I'm actually very excited for this project. It definitely feels like something I could use and I would like to use. What I wanted to know is that are there retailer profiles or can I browse SKUs? It just feels like I might want to know what's upcoming or what I missed. Also, are there any plans to implement a reward system?
Yes, exactly. So thank you very much for the kind words and for the question. So first of all, dealing with the retailers, any retailer that you've authorized has the ability to tell you that things are there. You can also wish list an item. You'll know when the price has changed. You'll have all these kind of wonderful things, but it's decentralized. You know, the Shopin profile is there for you to have control of your data, to have all the efficiencies, to log on to every website or every single app. We don't sell anything inside Shopin because then we'd become another centralized centralized system that disenfranchises the brands. So you will be able to get alerts from the people that you authorized, and in your activity feed, you'll be able to change the permission settings. This also, by the way, makes any retailer that joins us instantly GDPR compliant, which is super important to them. But we don't go out to sell them something on the sell side of the business. We give them something on the buy side of the business. We make them something which is amazing. We give them something which is going to make them money. With regards to the reward systems, that's what the whole point of the Shopin token. Point systems today are broken. Okay, the points have no value. They have to be burnt every single year, generally. The 100 points at J.Crew means nothing in J.Crew Canada to J.Crew USA. They don't mean the same thing. You can't transfer points from one person to another. They're not backed by anything, and you can't use the point systems across brands. So, and by the way, they're like fruit. They go bad. Nobody told me about that. Which kind of sucks because you use my money and use my time to make more money as a brand. So rather what we do is we have a cryptocurrency. And the cryptocurrency relates to the value of your data as it's become known over time, translating into converted dollars and cents and an understanding of the difference between revenue and margin. And based on that, this becomes essentially a token for you to access the person's data. And that token can be swapped around from person to person. You can share it with your friends and family. It goes up over time as there's greater market adoption. And there's no borders. And there's no commissions or middlemen involved. The retailer receives the token. They have the option to shapeshift it immediately down to the dollar value on the day against the price, against the purchase price of the item, or to hold on to it as an asset.
Thank you, Eran.
Thank you very much for your time today.
You know where to find Eran. That's